Hi, welcome back to Simply Maker channel. In today's video, I like to make a custom enclosure for this Sonoff NSPanel Pro. This smart panel is designed to be mounted on the wall and powered by the main AC. But with the enclosure, you'll have the flexibility to move it around and be safe from the main power. I've also included an AC socket, so you can easily take out the power cord if you need to. And optionally, you can also add an inline switch, which allows you to reset the device without unplugging it. The Sonoff NSPanel Pro runs on Android OS, which means we can do some hacks to run a Home Assistant companion app. If you want to know how to do this, I've put the links to the tutorials I used in the video description below. So let's see how I make it. I've designed this enclosure with minimal overhang to make it easy to print without needing additional support. So let's start with putting the M3 hot melt insert nut into the provided hole located at the front of print part. Next, I'll be using the C8 power inlet socket, just like the one I used in my previous video for the PD charger project. I've connected 18 AWG wires to the pins of the inlet, and then covered them with heat shrink tubing. Secure the inlet socket to the enclosure using 10mm M3 screws and M3 nuts. Trim off any excess wires and redden them as necessary. Insert a flathead screwdriver into the slot under the panel, ensuring that the screwdriver sits beneath the metal plate, and gently twist to detach the back panel from the screen. Connect the wires from the inlet to the panel, then tighten the locking screws. Now, secure the back plate to the enclosure using 10mm M3 screws. Reattach the screen to the back panel. I've included an anti-slip sheet underneath the printed part by repurposing the protective foam that was included with the panel. The foam sheet perfectly fits the enclosure width. Just put on a thin double-sided tape to the print part, and cut off any excess tape. Lastly, you have an option to include the inline AC switch for easily cutting off the main power supply. And there you have it. I hope you found this enclosure useful and practical for your needs. Remember to check the video description for downloadable files and helpful links. If you like my design and enjoy this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting content. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, stay creative and keep making. Thank you for watching.